Chris Bradshaw, 1215. Chris Bradshaw, 1215.
As old enough as I can remember, I love tearing stuff apart, fixing it. My mom's hair dryer was broken, so I'm like, I'll tear it apart, and then it got working and she took it back.
Well, the guys are into CrossFit now, so we have all that stuff, and pretty much everything you need is here, so we're pretty fortunate, actually.
My mom was a nurse and both my grandmas were nurses, so I always kind of knew I wanted to go into nursing. So I get to do vitals, I get to change the diapers on the kids. Not the best job, but it comes with the territory.
It's a lot different than cooking at Toll's because at Toll's we are more guided by Chef Needles, and here we kind of get a recipe and go. We're kind of on our own, but and then get critiqued.
What kind of food do they eat? They eat a lot of grass hay, and they get fruits and veggies for training, and then they get grain as well for breakfast. Any other questions? Nope.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome. Have a good day.
So our sea lions, they were shot by fishermen, and they weren't able to be rehabilitated and re-released, so they came here to live.
I think this is my old locker. Oh, they must have changed the combination.
Well, back in the 80s, I mean, technical education was fairly new, and there was kind of a stigma of kids that went to school here. So it was kind of a tough decision as a, you know, sophomore, junior in high school trying to make that decision. I got a lot of flack from my friends. Why was I doing something like that?
I think there was a very small percentage of people that went to Toll's just to escape their homeschool because it was an opportunity to get away from the negative things they might have been experiencing there. But that small percentage just blew up and became the stigma for what Toll's was. It was just a place to escape and just choose any random program to do that. But I was very serious about being an art design student, and I think I definitely wasn't alone in that. A large part of the student body was like me and was very serious, was wanting to pursue a college education.
Mine's behind Maury. There's a group of four dorms over here. And then on the other side of campus, there's two more all-female dorms.
Toll's gave me more of a calling, I guess. It helped me find out what I wanted to do.
For me, the college route made more sense, because I thought it would give me even more of a leg up in the industry. Chef, can the pâte de crème be on 250 on fan speed 2?
Yes.
Okay.
Toll's offers college courses, so I was able to take my college algebra 1 and 2 for free. So I got that out of the way. I didn't have to pay for it in college, and I didn't have to struggle with it because the teachers in high school, you know, they definitely worked with you a lot better than the college teachers would.
So this is our over-the-counter lab here at Finley. We had something similar to this at Toll's.
They have taught me so much, and Mrs. Haskell was a wonderful teacher, probably the best I've had by far. She made sure that all of her students kept up with the material and that we knew what we were doing, and she even told us, this is what you will learn some of this in college. So she touched up on it, even though we didn't really need it at Toll's, because she wanted to prepare us, because I believe my class had about 4 students that were planning on going on to pharmacy school.
My instructor, and I feel like the rest of them at Toll's, really push you to places that you probably wouldn't push yourself. She really taught us about how in the industry you won't always be doing things that you want to do. It's about taking challenges and making it into something that you can be passionate about regardless of what the challenge is. And that really kind of opened my eyes, and now even if I'm getting an assignment that I don't necessarily agree with or have as much emotion to as I would something I would choose on my own, I still tackle it with the same amount of tenacity as I would anything else. I'm in here almost every day, or at least two or three times a week, to get sketching done.
Well, I mean, it's so funny. You wish that as sophomores, I mean, I know probably some of the juniors hear it, but even as sophomores, when they're kind of contemplating what they're going to do, you wish they could hear from the colleges about how important it is to have a rounded resume. And I don't know, that's what we tried to stress to our kids, was that rounded resume is key. When you're in this environment, you're actually learning, actually doing hands-on, is what really teaches you and prepares you for your future.
Once I kind of sat back and thought about it and realized TOLS was an option, I realized I could be going somewhere and spending all that time with one instructor, all that time focusing on one specific area, and still be taking the classes I need that are required for graduation. So it wouldn't make sense to stay here and be jumping from class to class if I'll be getting more hands-on experience in a different building.
Some information I can remember just by reading it or having it lectured at me, but when it comes to cooking, I can't read how to make a beurre blanc. I have to have someone show me because you can read a syrupy texture in a textbook, but I don't think you exactly know what reduction level or syrupy texture you're looking for when you're making sauces.
Part of our training is obviously we have to go out and do it. So every day you go in there and you're doing the drills and the physical activity that you need to do, so it gets your body somewhat prepared for it. But more it's you. You have to have the right mental state of mind, and you have to be physically ready for it. You can go there and they can teach you everything and tell you everything that you need to know, but you have to be willing to do it and go above and beyond and not rely on them. You have to be your own person. You have to be extremely driven.
Now let's talk about difference between African and Asian elephants. Back up. Trunk foot. Christy, back up.
So zookeeping is a hard field to get into. It's very competitive. Like, I am out here sweating every day. It's not the most glamorous job, and a lot of people are like, why do you do this? I was like, because I get to teach people about animals. I get to work with them closely. I have a relationship with them, and I do get to do all that medical stuff that I learned at TOLS and at working at a animal hospital. We do our own blood draws. We have trained for x-rays. We do all our med administering. So just all of that has helped with my job here.
Well, it just shows you how much things change over, Wow. Well, my dad was the first superintendent, and he started here in 1971. Well, back in the 70s, Dad was the only employee, and he found someone to be his administrative assistant, and she literally had a cardboard box as her desk. And Dad came to work with a pen and a notepad, and that's kind of how it all started. He never tried to push, you know, decisions one way or the other. He always, as adults, let us try to make those decisions.
As soon as I found out about it, I was like, yeah, this is where I want to go, because they offer the college courses and they offer the accreditation, so I was able to walk away with certificates. My parents were all for it. My friends were a little skeptical, only because of what their parents had said. So, but I think it definitely changed their perception, because a lot of them, when I graduated, were saying how they wish that they had went.
A lot of people haven't had experience with technical programs. My parents had never even heard about TOLS or any program like it before, so it was a totally foreign concept to them. Once I sat down and really explained to them what it was, they were quick to jump on board and be supportive.
You know, come through high school, I wasn't sure what I was going to do. And probably when I toured Tools, I still wasn't exactly sure. My mom actually encouraged me to go to Tools and, you know, look at the programs. And my grandfather and great-grandfather are both firemen. So, you know, I was like, well, I'll go check out the fire and EMS program.
I was worried about leaving my friends, maybe losing contact with them, as ridiculous as that seems. But I understand that that's fully real for other people to think as well. Also, I was really involved at my home school. I was in the marching band, and I had started a club at my school. I was in other clubs at Davidson. But once I got to Tolls, I still found involvement in those areas.
Being at Tolls was definitely more focused, and if you knew what you wanted to do, then Tolls would really hone those skills. And if you weren't completely sure, then you'd have some time to figure it out, because there were so many programs you would get a chance to get a taste of before you narrowed it down to one.
A girl. I decided my senior year that I didn't want to become a veterinarian. I had battled with it for a while, and I finally went and talked to my advisor, and I was like, hey, you know, this isn't really what I want to do anymore. And she looked at me and she goes, I kind of saw that. I was like, great. Why didn't you tell me? She goes, I wanted you to figure it out on your own. These guys love to be scratched and touched, so they will stick around for as long as they will get some love. I mean, I had my heart set on being a veterinarian since I was in middle school, probably. I just loved it, but just going through that process and knowing, you know, you can change your mind once you get to college. You don't have to be dead set. It was a little stressful on me just because I didn't have a lot of time left, and I was like, oh my gosh, I have like 6 months before I graduate. I don't know what I'm gonna do with my life. But yeah, getting into Tolls, doing the program that you think that you really want to do, and going for it, like, that'll give you a good idea if you want to do that for the rest of your life. And I think it's a great opportunity for kids to be able to have that chance.
I think if I didn't go to Tolls, I'd probably be working at McDonald's somewhere. This machine, they use this in a lot of medical stuff because it has a vision system and it would take a picture of whatever. And they actually use it to sort pills and everything in the pharmacy. So you'll actually find these in hospitals. But they use this for medicine and they sort pills with this. A lot of your pills aren't actually hand counted, a robot does it.
I mean, technology was really the big thing at the time. IBM was just kind of becoming the big thing, and it was a big decision, and I'm sure a big expense for the school, but they saw that vision and invested in it.
Because that's the coolant that's pouring out. And that's how quickly it's spraying it. It's actually so accurate that it's tracked by the government, because we can actually make nuclear weapon parts with it, because it's that accurate. It was amazing. The day flew by compared to, you know, sitting in a classroom, doing nothing, and watching the time, going to Tolls, the time just flies by. I mean, you can't wait to the next day to go to school.
My instructor, she got to know me on a very personal level, and once she knew that I wanted to pursue fashion design, she would take time away to specifically give me projects tailored around my needs to be a fashion design student. So coming here, there were a lot of people that had never even touched a sewing machine before, never handled fabric, never worked on Illustrator, Photoshop, but I had had all those skills just from that one class. There's two ways to make a garment. You can either draw it on a flat piece of paper and then cut the fabric out from there, or you can start with the fabric on the dress form, decide how you like the shape, and then cut additional pieces from that shape that you created. This is almost like the pattern piece of paper as you would originally draw it. So you just go around all of these lines with a pencil very accurately and very carefully, then you unpin it, take it off, and this piece then becomes what you use to cut the rest of your fabric in. So say I did want to add blue at a certain area here. I would use the trace piece I had cut out, transfer it to paper, and then cut the blue fabric from that paper, because I know it'll fit exactly since I traced it once it was on the dress form.
Where'd she go? Okay.
Small guess.
Yeah. There's probably some larger ones too. Don't torch my hand. We're making some, I'm making some chocolate pâte au crème for the student dining hall. Bake Shop 7, where we're at. We make all the desserts for the downstairs dining hall here in Roth Hall. And other students who have returned from extern in their bake shops make the bread and baked goods for other things. We just happen to have downstairs. Well, we're going to be making bread for our sandwich project. And probably starting on our ice cream base for our ice cream project for tomorrow.
Once I got onto a competition team at Tolls, and it was the Pro Start Culinary team my junior and senior year. Those long hours being at school till 11 p.m., midnight sometimes, even while I had homework, I was finding my passion, learning to cook. I knew that it was exactly what I wanted to do.
I've been here, it'll be 3 years and a couple of months. Since kids bounce back so well, it's awesome to just see them transition from coming to me and not being able to breathe whatsoever and being on oxygen and having to have treatments every 2 hours to 2 days later, if not sooner, they're running around their room.
I go over to the rec center when I'm not studying. I try to do some physical activities. Like I said, I volunteer. I play Xbox with my friends sometimes. It's just whatever's in the moment, whatever seems like fun at the time. I feel like in college, it's a lot more in-depth. You have a lot more freedom associated with college.
Hard living here only because you get distracted by so many things and you just want to explore and go out and do things. But at the same time, here, everyone is somebody. Everyone is pursuing some kind of career. Everyone's in college, and being surrounded by those types of people just inspires you to work harder. For me, it's almost more motivational to be in charge of my own fate, because back home, if someone would tell you to do something, sometimes it became more tempting not to do it because you wanted to prove that you can make your own decisions. So here, with everything in my hands, I become more motivated and more inspired to show up to class, to do my work, because it's all my own choice. I can't blame anyone else if I don't succeed.
Reachable goals, I feel like, are important, and then also setting goals that you may never reach but you're always striving for are huge. When I went to Columbus State, I was hoping to get in their paramedic program, and test score wasn't high enough, or hey, you know, I was right there at the edge, but I didn't make it. So it was kind of like, okay, well, step back, recess. Now what can I do? I know this is what I want to do. This is my goal. So what am I going to do? So at that point, I started looking around, and I found out, you know, about grants program I'd never even heard of. And I pursued that, and I got right in and haven't looked back since. It was an awesome experience. That was just one stepping stone in the whole process.
One of the hardest things I had to deal with coming out here was leaving my entire family back in Ohio. I actually did two interviews here with Hogle. I did one earlier in the spring last year, and they actually hired one of the guys I work with, Jason. Even though I interviewed and I didn't get picked for it, I got the best rejection letter I could have ever gotten. I got an email in November, and he's like, hey, I have another position open in Elephants. Are you still looking? I was like, yes, I am. He goes, well, good, because I want to do another interview with you. I was like, all right, awesome. So I did the interview. It went great.
Stanley actually came to Tolls looking for people, and they said, submit your resume, and we'll see what happens. So I submitted my resume, and they called me in for an interview, and then they hired me. And then I worked full-time over the summer. But then I still continue to work and go to school.
I was able to apply to Nationwide Children's Hospital, and it's actually a really competitive place to get into. So that having those certificates helped me get in here.
I find that there are so many things that I want to learn still as an adult, and that's something you can take with you just in your life. Dad was so impressed with the school and how far it had come, and he could hardly believe that after all these years, this is what it ended up being. And he was so humbled by it all. And I think it was just seeing kind of his vision come to fruition and even beyond. He was so impressed by all the different programs that are offered here. And I think it kind of solidified for him what he always had felt in his own mind, his vision.